Hi guys, today our topic is derivation of single block or shoe brake. It comes under the topic of brakes. So we know the subject, design of machinery elements too. We know that, so designing means we know how to designs we use by the solid works, AutoCADs, and we have, for mechanic students, we have a different type of software for designing. So that's none of our topic now. So the main work of brakes used to stop or halt of vehicles. So while doing this, we can have some that means it produce some heat, and by using some mechanisms we can stop the vehicle. So those type of mechanisms, there are some mechanisms there. So those mechanisms, how they are work and how to design, so comes under this topic. So let's start. So here we have three cases. So in this one, the first case is for a single block or a shoe brake is this one. This is the first case. So here, this is our brake drum. This is our brake drum. It has a radius R, and so we can apply the force here. This is the force, nothing but force. So if this brake drum, if you think that this brake drum is rotating in a clockwise or anti-clockwise, so for our consideration we are taking it in a clockwise direction. So it is rotating in this direction, so it has some forces. If you can take a point at this point, so it has some force at this point. That force is Ft. So that is nothing but tangential force. We can call it as a tangential force. So Ft equal to tangential force of brake drum. So if you think that here this is the at this point, so when this force is applied, so the contact between the contact between this mechanism and this brake drum take place. So the maximum effect take place here, and sides are, they will take minimum effect, but the maximum effect take place at the center. So if we take this point here, at this point on brake drum, it produces the force Ft. This is the friction, not friction force, sometimes it's called the friction force also. So it is nothing but tangential force. So here, the perpendicular to this one, it applies this brake drum. Apply, that means this brake drum produce normal force Fn, Rn. We think that is Rn. So we have forces, and we have required forces, but we need distances. So the distance between this axis to, so this one is x. Think that x. Sometimes we can call this x equal to fulcrum distance. Sometimes they call as fulcrum distance, and the distance between here to this force is L. This one is L. So we have required forces and required length also. So by using the momentum diagrams, not the momentum diagrams, by using the momentum, we can easily formulate this one. So here it is in equilibrium, so the momentum is zero always. So we are taking that this one is a fixed point. So we have a force at this one and this one and this one. Three, we have three forces and their respective directions are. So if you take this is a fixed force and this is a force and this moment diagram like this. And this one, this is the force and this is fixed force. This momentum is like this. And this also, this momentum like this. So based on this one, we can draw a few, that means if you equal the momentums, we can get Rn is equal to Rn is equal to and perpendicular distance is x. Perpendicular distance nothing but x here into x equal to it is in one direction and the remaining two are in the same directions. So we are equating them. So force into and perpendicular distance between P and fixed position is L. This is L. And also we have Ft. And it is zero because of the Ft, the nothing but tangential force is passing through the fixed point. So if the force is passing through the fixed point and it will not produce, it can't produce the momentum. So the perpendicular distance between the fixed position and tangential position and this fixed one is zero. So we'll consider this one as zero. So by equating them, we can get Rn equal to P into L by X. So we know that the torque produced by breakdown is nothing but and the tangential force into the radius of breakdown. We know that the radius of breakdown. So here we know that it produces a here, the contact take place, so it produces some we can get here we can get a coefficient, friction coefficient, we can get a friction coefficient u. So we know that friction coefficient is nothing but Ft by Rn. Ft by Rn. So we can get Ft equal to u into Rn in. So by substituting this one here, we can get the torque equal to U into Rn into R. So R is the radius of breakdown. R is radius of breakdown. This is derivation about. Now come to second case. So there is little difference between first case and second case. Here everything is same, but so the that means the friction there is some gap between the fixed point and the friction force. That is called that nothing but we are taking as a. So same thing, we have forces. We have three forces and we have a required length also. So by applying the momentum, we can get the relations. So we know that momentum equal to zero. So it is in the equilibrium conditions. So again, we are that means applying the momentums, momentum equilibrium. So we can get the relations. So we are taking this one as a fixed point. This one and this one we have three forces and this direction is like this and this direction like this and this direction is also like this. So then R has one direction and remaining P and F has both have same direction. So we can apply the momentum equations. So Rn into perpendicular direction is called x equal to P into perpendicular distance equal to L plus. So here at the first case we have the Ft, the tangential force passing through fixed point, but here for the second case it's not passing through the fixed point, it has some perpendicular distance. So the tangential force has some perpendicular distance, so Ft is equal to L. Same like by derivating this one, that means by equating Rn into x equal to p into l plus here this is the tangential force. So we have an equation like e is equal to friction coefficient so ft by Rn. So we can get here ft equal to u into Rn. Yes, so by substituting Rn is equal to u into Rn, we can get u into Rn into a. So we have, but at both sides we have Rn and Rn, so we can get Rn. So Rn x minus u into Rn a is equal to pl. So we can take a common, take R as a common, so x minus u into a equal to p into l. So Rn equal to pl by x minus u a. This is Rn, this is Rn. So this is for at clockwise directions, this is for a clockwise direction. So if we thought that it is a clockwise direction like this, for the anti-clockwise direction we can have Rn equal to pl by x plus ua. X plus ua for, sorry guys, for clockwise direction. This is for clockwise direction. And we know that torque equal to ft into r. So we know that ft is equal to u into rn. So rn is nothing but for our condition rn is equal to pl by x minus ua. So pl by x minus ua into r, this is the torque required for case 3. So here the friction force, that means the point where the friction force is there, that means the time f tangential is somewhat high then compared to then by taking a this one as a reference is somewhat high. So by comparing them, for first condition it is equal to fixed position, and for second condition it is below the fixed position, for third condition it is somewhat high to high than the fixed position. So same, we are applying again m equal to 0, and by derivating Rn